Set for a good AFC matchup between the Baltimore Ravens and the New England Patriots. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Now a first carry for LeGarrette Blount. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. And Blount had a nice touchdown run this past week against the Rams. I think on it was fourth and one. He bounced it outside, didn't he?
Yeah, exactly when you would expect him to get the ball. Fourth and one, have him power in between the guards, you know, and get a first down. But as you noted, able to bounce it outside and then showed some speed that I'm not sure a lot of people thought that he possessed and took it the distance. Ended up having an 88-yard day.
Brady now to throw. Over the middle, that's caught by Hogan. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue.
That crossing route is so effective when you hit it just right because you get a guy on the move, and then we see the end result there.
Nightmare for the defense. They got a guy with a full head of steam.
Not only does he catch it, but he picks up additional yardage after it.
Brady now on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
That coach is always harp on the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Brady gives now to Blount. And he's going to be met at about the 43. Call it a gain of four on first, and that'll make it second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down following the run. Ready to throw on second down. And this one complete to Martellus Bennett. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line.
Well, I know it goes against the instincts of the person catching the ball because all you're ever taught is catch the football, don't drop it.
But drop it there.
Yeah, in that situation, dropping it would have been better. End up losing yardage even though they completed the pass.
As good as a sack.
Yeah, how about that? Although they won't get the same credit for it, and it won't help them at contract time.
They'll run again with Blount, and he is going to lose yardage here. So he got his hands a little too far outside. The ref caught him, threw the flag.
I mean, that was an example of why offensive linemen might want rearview mirrors at times, because you have your assignments to block, but if you can see what's going on in the backfield and maybe the guy carrying the ball is headed in another direction, it might change what you do up front. But if they can't see that, and he's not in sync with what they're doing up front, well, this is when you end up with plays like this. A bad one for the offense, a really good one for the defense.
And complete on the right side to Bennett. That catch good for five. It's third down.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do, and it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
Now Brady. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. C.J. Mosley able to get him down for a loss of 11 on the play, and it'll be fourth down. So on fourth down, the left-footed Ryan Allen to kick it away for the Pats. Back deep is Devin Hester. And this is going to hit the goal line and continue on into the end zone for a touchback. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field.
Ringo, Ringo, Ringo.
first and 10, and Flacco looking to throw. And his first pass is incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. And on second and 10 now. Now a carry here for Terrence West. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football.
Wow, that ball gets knocked free, but a teammate comes along and scoops it up. It's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get them home, the next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. Now West. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and 5. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Second quarter now. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis with you. It's the Ravens who have the football. They've got a second down at 5 here to start things out. They'll run again here with West. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down.
An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. Third down, Flacco from the gun. And it's brought in by Pitta. And he's got the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 49. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
Now that's the type of play that'll fire up a defense, holding them to 1 yard on a first down run. It'll be interesting to see if the offense decides to press the run at all, or if they'll abandon it now after gaining only 1 on that play.
On the ground, it's West again, looking to find a lane, but he can't, reined in at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. Third down, Flacco needs a decent chunk of yardage. And this is going to be incomplete. Mike Wallace, the intended receiver, and that'll bring up a 4th down. Now the longtime Raven punter, Sam Cook, on to punt it away. Back deep, Danny Amendola for New England. And it's out of bounds. Now we'll see what the side judge says. He says out at the 8-yard line. And now New England will take over again on offense, sitting at 10-2. But the big news, of course, losing Rob Gronkowski. Back surgery on December 2nd last week. Done for the year.
This was his 3rd back surgery, so everybody's very concerned about his health and him coming back to play. But now they've got to adjust on offense without him. They had such a great tandem with he and Martellus Bennett, the other tight end position. But Bennett, he's a Pro Bowl player in his own right. They can shift everything to him and have everyone else pick up the slack.
And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? Almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility? 20, 20,
Again, here's Blunt. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. 1 yard officially on the pickup, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 11.
Well, it wasn't much of a gain, but we're getting near the 2-minute warning, so maybe they just want to get to that point, regroup, and decide what they want to do the rest of the half.
And they'll be in search of 11 yards here on 3rd down. They come out here in the eye. Now a carry for the shifty Deion Lewis. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. Here's Ryan Allen now, on for his 2nd punt. He'd take a repeat of his 1st. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Just a yard return there after a punt of 49. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Now the Baltimore offense heading back out onto the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. Here comes the Raven offense now, ready for another possession. And last time out, they had to punt the football away. Anything positive possibly to take from that?
There always is when you're punting the football away. It doesn't sound like it because you're giving it up, but you've avoided a mistake.
At least you didn't turn it over.
You didn't turn it over, right? You're giving your defense a chance because you're punting the ball away and they're set to go on the field, as opposed to sudden change after a turnover. Wow, now we got to go out there and stop people. So, yeah, there's always something positive to be gained from it.
It'll go as a gain of 10 there, and that'll be good for a Baltimore first. It's a 5-receiver set, 3 to the left, 2 to the right. 1st and 10 here for Flacco. And Aiken with it over the middle. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. That throw good for 4. It's 2nd down. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is that now with his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. And they're 6 yards away from picking up the 1st here on 2nd down. Flacco here on 2nd down. And hauled in by Pitta. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. That man, Dennis Pitta, what a comeback story. You were telling me off air, they weren't sure that he was going to play again.
In fact, I did a couple of Baltimore games last year, and people in their administration said, we love Dennis Pitta, but we just don't think he'll ever play again coming off the injuries he's had. These were his 1st touchdowns since the 2013 season. Let's give this guy a ton of credit for perseverance and getting back to a big-time level of play.
Yeah, 90 yards in addition to those two touchdown catches in Week 13. Welcome back, Mr. Pitta.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. They fake the handoff. Now Flacco, pressure up the middle, and down he goes. Dante Hightower leading the surge there. He drops him for a loss of six. He didn't get rid of the football there, took the sack, although that's easier said than done. He can't just chuck the thing sideways into the seats.
No, he really can't, because you're not afforded total protection as a quarterback. You have to get outside of the tackle boxes as defined by the NFL, meaning wherever your tackles operate normally, get outside of that. And the ball that you throw has to get back to at least the line of scrimmage. Otherwise,
the ball popped in the air and intercepted. Picked off by Patrick Chung. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. Yeah, the ball backed way up. So thinking with this amount of time on the clock, probably just sit on it, and we'll see these two teams go to the lockers.
Yeah, I don't think you want to overthink it in this situation. Either side of the ball, just go ahead and finish up the half and get on out and talk about it.
So plenty of action on the field, but no action right now on the scoreboard, at least as of yet. Nothing is our score. As we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry, on the return, the old reliable Devin Hester, the veteran. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. There are 0 points on the scoreboard for either side. It'll be interesting to see what adjustments were made. The defenses have obviously been great.
So if you like defense, this is a classic game. This is what you're looking for. But now you're trying to figure out how to gain any type of an advantage on offense. Is it through a big chunk play that they haven't seen before? Or is it just running your regular offense and running it better, trying to create an opportunity?
We'll see which avenue they choose to go down.
And when all else fails as a defender, when you're not there in the coverage, your best friend is exactly what we saw there. A big play shot taken by the offense. Unfortunately, it ended in a big drop.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down. Flacco to throw again on second down. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
I know they don't like to hear it when they get to a certain age, but then you have to start to use your skills, your wiles, right, your mind to beat guys to the football. And getting your toes tapped inbounds definitely qualifies as that, doesn't it?
The veteran showing he still has the agility. From the gun, Flacco. He's got time. And incomplete. He had nowhere to throw, so he just tossed it away. But that brings up fourth. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it. And in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Pulled in at the 24. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. Their defense did its job, yielded no points. Now it's the offense's turn.
And how much fun is that when you set things up to start a half and you just tell you guys, hey, if you can shut them down, get it back for our offense, we can roll. And they played out perfectly. Now, can the offense do what they wanted to do at the half, which is find those weaknesses and now attack them and score some points.
And break this tie. Lawrence Guy able to bring him down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Now Brady throwing on second down. And he dumps it off to Blunt. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker, or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. Blunt, the lone running back. Snap comes at one, and it's Brady. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete. And he's certainly not a guy that drops that football very often.
Indeed, because that's a bit of a surprise. I know he's in the middle of some traffic and people, bodies all around him, but he usually has the focus to haul that one in.
And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Throwing is Brady on third down. This is White on the screen. And he's got room. And he's going to be out of bounds down around the 35-yard line.
Let's give a little credit there. The offensive play caller sensed that the screen pass was available. Whenever you're getting a lot of heavy pressure towards your quarterback, that's when you're thinking about running the screen and using that pressure against the defense. And it worked very well there for a first down.
Now a play fake here on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Everything looked right on that play except the conclusion. He dropped it. An in route going into a little bit of traffic. Maybe in the back of his mind he was wondering where the hit was going to come from.
Second down now after the incompletion. They'll run it now out of the gun. Call it no gain on the run there, and now they'll be looking at a third down. Boy, that's a lot of sirloin steak to be taken down for no gain, partner.
Are you trying to suggest that he is a huge man?
He is.
Not just a big man, a huge man.
Big, big boy.
Well, how about the credit then for the defense to be able to chop that big tree and put him on the ground?
I know back when you played, it took four of you to take a guy like that down, right?
Well, that's for sure. And you know what, know what else? I didn't want to challenge him at dinner either.
Caught, left side, Benner. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down.
Have we yet met a receiver that wasn't excited about getting a chance to play with Tom Brady?
Absolutely not.
And Martellus Bennett bringing his considerable skills to New England now. Going to hook up with Mr. Brady for another completion here.
Yeah, 90 catches a couple years ago in Chicago, 53 last year for Bennett. Blunt, the lone running back. And they'll give it to him here. Trucks through him.
Oh, man, right through him.
Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Well, at least he was able to break that initial contact, or it could have been a loss.
Yeah, give credit to the defensive player, though. What did he do? Made him slow down, slow up his feet, and allowed the rest of the guys to get there to finish him off.
So second and 10 here. Now Blunt. And they'll get him down right around the 16. Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a third and 8 situation. And the seemingly endless drive continues. A nickel back added defensively as they look to stop this third and 8. Shotgun now for Brady. And that is incomplete. Back now in Foxborough, as it looks like we are just about set and ready to begin with the fourth. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and the Patriots jump out to a 3-0 lead. So it took a while to get something, anything, on the scoreboard, but we finally have our first points of the contest.
And now this becomes a question of, can they make this stand up? The defense has been impeccable thus far, and now they need to go out and finish strong.
Gostkowski now converted for three. Now he'll kick this one away. This one fielded at the five. Oh, spinning away. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how starved they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. They go play action here on first down. So they took a shot on first down but couldn't connect. Well, they haven't had a whole lot of success in the passing game here. Now in the second half, he's thinking, I guess maybe just take a shot deep.
I think you're right. Almost looking for a bailout, isn't he? Can my receiver go up and make a big play for me? Can I create a penalty downfield, maybe pick up an interference call and get that yardage downfield? Anything trying to get going again, but you're right. He definitely took a shot.
Flacco to the right side to Aiken. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
I know many people like to throw to the tight end, maybe in a little flexed out position because he creates mismatches with his size. But slot receivers do the same thing with their quickness, their speed, and their route running savvy.
So completion on second down, that brings up third. Third down, Flacco from the gun, finding time. And it's brought in by Pitta. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
So the offense has it first and 10. First and 10 here for Flacco. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, no, he lost the football.
On plays like this where the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back because this is the quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or have moved away from him. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Second down, Flacco now. Throwing left side, it's complete. A nice pickup there, 19 yards. And they're set up better for third.
Rashad Perriman is just gifted athletically. And I know we got a scare back in, what was it, June? We thought maybe a second knee injury might miss a second year. But he came back, and he came back strong.
He played with his dad, didn't you?
Yeah, I played against his dad in college, and he turned out to be a heck of an NFL player. But Rashad, he's got a chance to really be special.
This is West. And he's going to have the first down yardage as he's down at about the 30-yard line. 5 yards is the pickup there as that extends this drive.
I don't know about you, but that almost felt like old-time football there. Third and two is not necessarily just a running down anymore. A lot of times they want to throw the ball. They went back to the roots and powered forward and got the first down.
They look to throw on first and 10 with Flacco. Surveying the field and hauled in by Pitta. That throw good for four. It's second down.
Well, the strategy was evident there. Get it to your tight end and make it a one-on-one play with a cornerback. Who's usually going to win that one?
The tight end, but not there.
Not in this situation. How about the corner defeating that logic and making a really nice tackle?
Six yards here to go for the offense on second down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he will be stopped here for no gain, and that is going to take us to the two-minute warning.
And quickly, they get to the line. They'll look to throw.
Looking left side, he's got it complete. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
A short game that doesn't get them the first down brings up a fourth down situation.
Really nice job defensively. They knew where the sticks were. They got the stop before it.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. On the left hash mark, this a 38-yard attempt. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And we are all tied here in the final stages. So this hasn't exactly been a battle of one touchdown after another, but at 3-3 now here in the fourth, it's been a pretty doggone entertaining game.
Yeah, it's kind of like a pitcher's duel in baseball, don't you think? The aficionados can appreciate a tightly fought game like this.
Yeah, but the fantasy players, not so much. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have stayed where he was as he'll only get back to the 16-yard line. And the Patriots gearing up to go now. And after the field goal last time, let's see what they can get here. At least they got points out of the last drive, Charles.
I never met an offensive coach that didn't want a drive to end with a kick. Most of them wanted to end with a PAT, right? In this case, a field goal, they'll take it. Way better than the alternative, which is a punt.
Yeah, but you met fan bases that wanted that, that weren't happy with that field goal.
I haven't met a fan base yet that wants to drive to end with a kick other than the extra point. That's it.
Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds.
Let's make this one simple. What a catch, especially the finishing part of getting his feet in bounds, toe tapping, and of course, foot dragging.
Little tapestry, if you will.
Oh, I like it.
Back to throw, Brady. And complete on the right side to Bennett. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Brady to throw. And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Now Brady. He's got time. Incomplete. So holding by the offense and maybe now got to shift up what you want to do on the playbook.
Yeah, definitely. Change what you're doing in the playbook, but boy, the advantage shifts to the guys on defense, doesn't it? Longer yardage situations, they often become bolder.
Well, timeout on their side here. In fact, a lot going against them. They do have a small glimmer of hope.
No one likes to play extra football. They want to go for the win right now.
To throw is Brady. And he's just going to get rid of this thing. To no one here. He throws it away. And now it's third. It looked like he might have had a window there, but the rhythm was just a little bit off.
Certainly was, because everything that has to come together to get a pass completed. Yeah, you're right. The sink just wasn't there.
Brady gives this one to Lewis. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. And now the Raven defense going to call a timeout.
It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages. Here's Ryan Allen now, as he's on to punt for New England. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. On the return, Hester. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive, as it'll begin in enemy territory already. His way forward here for a modest gain. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave them with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. So we've got a second and five. Here's West. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. They give him 14 yards that time and a fresh set of downs.
Whenever we meet with coaches and they always talk about wanting to establish running the football, it's oftentimes with a good tight end who can control the line of scrimmage and the point of attack, and they're becoming harder to find because the colleges are giving us a whole lot of receiving tight ends, former wide receivers who can run, not necessarily block very well. In this case, though, we saw two tight ends on the field, both of them with ability to block, and they ran the ball successfully behind that power set.
Nothing between these two teams for four quarters. Here we go to begin overtime. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. They start on the ground with West. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
To me, that's a superior play by the backer because he was allowed to, I think, run free on it and make that play. His defensive linemen, they cover things down for him because offensive guys, the linemen, what they're trying to do, as you know, is block the guy at the point of attack and then climb to the next level and get the linebacker. And you're not allowed to climb. You got a free hitter, and that's what we saw there. And a really nice play resulted for them.
7 yards on the play, and that's going to bring up a third down.
The completion was given up, and that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
Third and four. Third down, Flacco from the gun. And it's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. They've got some decisions to make now. In field goal range already. How do you play this out?
You check with your kicker to make sure the spot that he told you that he wants it is still the same as the game is going on, because sometimes the kickers have to make adjustments. They may all of a sudden become more confident about their range and their spot. They may become less confident about it. Where do you want it, and what is the range that we need to get into for you to kick the one through the post for us to win it?
So this game possibly could end on the foot of the kicker here in overtime. Throwing on first down is Brady. And he will find his man on the outside. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Brady to throw on second down. And he can't hang on. That's definitely going to be one he wishes he had back. Incomplete in the end zone.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it in the end zone. A big time drop.
Brady going to try and throw on third down. Finding time. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
You ever notice that when Tom Brady does get hit and drop to the ground, there's some guys back to him pretty quickly to check on his health, aren't there?
That's exactly right. For as much as he throws, doesn't take a lot of square shots, but took one there.
He's really smart in the pocket, isn't he? Even out of the pocket, he understands where the pressure's coming.
And now the Ravens are going to take another timeout. They'll be left with just one remaining here at OT. A big spot now for Steven Goskowski. From the left hash, should be a fairly easy one here. And he got it! The kick is good in overtime. He's able to split the uprights. We thought this game would be a good one. It did not disappoint into overtime, and it took the field goal to win it.
And we always pay lip service to how important it is to play defense. And usually we focus on the big offensive pyrotechnics, right? But in this case, they got the ball back on defense, gave themselves a chance, and they capitalized on it with a victory.
And I don't care what